Amazing. Thank you, guys. How are we doing? We good? Yes, amazing. I'm good too. Thanks for asking. Yeah, I'm out past my bedtime and it's great to be here speaking with you guys too. I'm also actually really quite proud to be here speaking with you, just because in all honesty, I've never really been that spate at greeting. Nice, good to see one or two of you are so pleasingly eased. I'll explain though. I was a very late talker as a kid, right? I didn't talk until the age of about 5 or 6. And up until that point, my older brother, he would talk for me. And of course, he used this to torment me. Just little things, you know, like making sure I didn't get that last little bit of sticky toffee pudding, or not telling my parents when I pooped my pants, or, you know, signing me up to be a Jehovah's Witness. At that point though, I had had enough, right? And so with pooping my pants, but God, in my heart, I decided to speak up. The only problem was I couldn't talk properly. I couldn't say my S's or my F's. I would say H's instead. Yeah, it turns out if you don't talk for 5 years, you get pretty hucking hit at it. As you guys can probably imagine, though, that speech impediment, a lot like this joke, gets pretty old, pretty damn fast. See? And so I was shipped off to speech therapy. Now, clearly it worked because I'm here and I'm speaking to you, but I didn't have the best time of it. I actually think what I was put through was really quite cruel. They took me, a kid who clearly could not talk, and they forced me to do tongue twisters. That to me, guys, is the exact same as taking Ben here, breaking both of his legs, and then shipping him off to Argentina to compete in Total Wipeout. That's cruel, right? It's a compelling watch, though. Everybody here is tuning in just to see how you get over those big red balls. And that to me, guys, was the exact same as having to drag my massive tongue through She Sells Seashells without calling my speech therapist a whore. If I'm being honest with you, guys, that whole experience, it massively knocked my confidence. I've had a low self-esteem ever since, and I used to have this really bad habit of negative self-talk. Yeah, I know, right? What a fucking loser. My dad, though, he saw this and he wanted to help. So he went out and he bought me a book on cognitive behavioral therapy, CBT. Hands up if you know what CBT is. Woo! Amazing. Got all the crazy people out in the open. Thank you, guys. Yeah, the book that my dad bought me was called CBT for Dummies. Yeah, and to make matters worse, he bought that book secondhand. He bought me a secondhand self-help book. It genuinely still had like notes and annotations in it from the guy who had it last. It was just like Harry Potter and the Half-Blood Prince. We know that film, right? Yeah, it was just like that, except where Harry got potions and spells, what I got were intrusive thoughts and some pretty dark farewells. What I will say about that book, though, guys, is the notes in it did so much more for my self-esteem than the book itself. Yeah, anybody that says comparison is the thief of joy has clearly never read a secondhand self-help book. That, though, guys, is a great example of my dad trying to help me, kind of slightly missing the mark. Another great example of this. When I was 16, I was diagnosed with anorexia. Yeah, it turns out an apple a day, it's not quite enough food to keep the doctor away. Don't worry though, guys, because I am so, so fine now. I'm fully recovered. And as I was told back then, it was very common in girls my age. My dad, though, like I said, he wanted to help with this, but being a poor, simple man from Liverpool, he didn't know how, he didn't understand it. So what my dad thought that he would do to help me is sneak into my room in the dead of night and slip a Snickers bar under my pillow. Yeah, it's pretty nuts, right? It's kind of like the Tooth Fairy, but with much more diabetes. He did this for a while too. When I finally got around to challenging him on this and saying, Dad, why are you doing this to me? All he could say to me is, oh, Luke, you're not you when you're hungry. He'd stolen it from those adverts. Remember those Snickers adverts? Yeah. Personally, I think my dad's a little bit too easily influenced by advertising. I don't know, maybe it's me, maybe it's him, or maybe it's Maybelline. My dad, though, he's actually a much better man than those stories make him out to be, guys. He loves three things in life. He loves his family, he loves Liverpool Football Club, and he loves making sausages, baby. Yeah, my dad's recently retired, and as a retirement present, I bought him a copy of Sausage Making for Dummies. Second hand, of course, it had to be. And he's rolling with it. And because he loves Liverpool so much, he wants to start a sausage-making company called Mo Salami. Mo Salah, of course, one of the best football players in the world right now, and a devout Muslim. Yeah, which means my dad's turned a well-meaning pork-related business into what is essentially a hate crime. Thanks, guys. You've been an absolute pleasure to talk to. I've been Luke Hall. I'll see you soon.